In today's video, I'll show you how to make a safe system that you can hack and will dispense cash just like this that you can collect and continue doing this over and over again. Without further ado, let's get right into the video. Okay, let's start off by pressing your view tab and opening up our output. This will be useful for displaying any errors that I might make or you might make. Okay, let's go into our model tab, press on one stud. This will be useful for creating our safe. I'm going to set my color to be this color and then make a part. I'm going to press F to lock on the part and then simply scale it to be a 3x3x3. And there we go. I now have this. I will now duplicate this and set my studs back to 0 so I can create a nice control panel like type structure on the safe. There we go. I'm now going to set this to be a lighter gray color. I can now anchor this and simply let's change the material right here to a metal color. Let's see if I can find metal. Metal. There we go. Now I have a more secure look to it and a more safe type material. Okay. Now let's duplicate this. Let's move this a little bit forward and scale this down a little bit. There we go. We can now rename this to money spawn. Whoops, money spawn. Okay, there we go. We can now select this money spawn and simply turn off can collide, meaning that our player cannot walk into this, and select as our, where is it? Select the transparency, if I can find it right there. Let's select that to 1. So now the player cannot see it and cannot collide with it. Now we can select all this and press Control and G to make a group, or actually a model. We can rename this model simply to safe because that's what it is. Okay, under money spawn, let's create a proximity prompt and let's also add in a script. We can delete what's in the script and close out of it. Next, let's rename the script to money spawn. That will spawn our money. And inside of here, we can do a few things. Like action text, we're going to call this hack, and our object text, we're going to call this to a safe. And then keyboard key, let's do H because we are going to hack the safe. And as an Xbox key, I'm going to do L1 because that's a little bit different than X. We can also set a hold duration to, let's say, 3. I think 3 is good. Okay, that's all you really have to change. Okay, once we're done this, let's start working on our money. I will make this money about 1.5 studs and make it a little bit flat. There we go. Next, let's leave anchored off so that we can have a nice falling type animation when it spawns in. Okay, now we have a part. Let's rename this to money. There we go. Inside of our money, we are going to add in a proximity prompt and another script. Let's rename this script to pick up. Okay, once you're at this point, make sure to go into this description and copy and paste this script right here, which is the leader stats, and put this into server script service. Okay, I'll wait a bit for you to do that, or you can pause the video. Okay, once you're done that, we can simply do is we can go in here and quickly create, we can detect when this proximity prompt has been triggered and it's complete. First, let's maybe make a little bit of improvements to this, like C to pick up, let's do L2 to pick up for Xbox, and for object text, we're going to call this money, and as an interact, we're going to go pick up, or actually, well, I think it'll be better to do collect. There we go. We now have this. What we can do here is we can go game dot, what we can do is script dot parent dot proximity prompt dot triggered colon connect function, and then inside of here we can do PLR, which is short for player. Next, we can simply press our enter key and it should autocomplete. If it doesn't, simply write down and enter, or you may have done something wrong on this line. Okay, next we can do is we can do PLR dot leader stats dot money dot, what is it, dot our value. Do not write what is it, that was just me thinking to myself. Now we have to do plus equals 10, which is how much we earn. Ah, I can't spell earn. How much we, you know, let's just do get. And let's fix that. I had some typing error problems right there. Now we can do is we can just go script dot parent colon. We're going to destroy this. Okay. Now this should work. What we now have to do is simply drag our money and place that into our replicated storage. This is a perfect place for storing items that we want to get replicated. Okay, we can now close both of these things up and go back into here. What we have to do is we have to go local replicated storage, which is what we're going to call, which is we're calling our local thing, which we're going to find what this is, which is replicated storage. So we have to do is we have to go game dot colon gets, we're going to get a service from our game, and the service is going to be replicated storage, which is this right here. We can now press enter, and we can go local part is going to be equal to script dot parent. Okay, now we can do is part, we can go with part dot proximity prompt dot triggered colon connect, and then we're going to go function. We don't have to place in PLR, and we can simply press enter. First, let's quickly create a function right here, which is going to be function. Actually, we're going to go ahead and create a local function. And what we can do is dupe cash, or dupe money, and place those two at the end. Press enter, and it should give you this simple end. Inside of here, let's do local money is going to be equal to replicated storage dot money. Okay, and then here what we can do is let's place in await 0.25. I'm just going to do this, and we can simply type in these two lines and give us ourselves a note, which is how long to wait. How long to wait. And I'm also going to do delete. Oh, can be deleted if not needed. There we go. Let's just do removed. I think that sounds a bit better. Okay, can be removed if not needed. Now we can do is let's create another. Let's skip a line just to make it a bit neater. And let's go local clone, which is going to be equal to money colon clone. Okay, now we have cloned our money at this point. And what we can do is we can go clone dot, let's go clone dot position. It's going to be equal to our part dot position. Okay, we now have our position. Now we can do is we can go clone dot parent, which we want to set our new parent of the clone, which clone dot parent is going to be equal to our, which is going to be equal to, no, we don't want to do clone dot parent. We want to do, no, yes, we do clone dot parent, which is going to be equal to work clone dot parent. No, clone dot parent is going to be equal to game dot workspace. Sorry, that took me a while to figure out. And then just so it drops, just so we can randomize the drops a bit, what we can do is we can go clone dot orientation is going to be equal to a new vector 3 dot new, and then simply I'm going to do 23, 34, and 4. This will a bit, this can make our falling look a bit more better. We could also randomize these by creating random numbers right here, but let's not do that. That's a bit more complicated. This should work just as fine. This should be able, so pretty much how what this will do is when the part falls, it'll fall in a different direction than the other part, which is nice. Okay, now inside of here, what we can do is we're going to call our function. So what we can do is we can go dupe money, and then dupe money, and then dupe money, and then dot dupe money. So every time we call this, it will play this code right here. So we don't have to constantly, if we didn't do that, we'd have to do this 4 times, which that's really messy. So let's not do that. It's much easier just to do dupe money, right? What we can do is we can also go prox. Let's also do part dot proximity prompt dot enabled equals false. And then right here, what we can do is part dot proximity prompt dot enabled equals true. Inside of here, what we can do is we can maybe make await 23. And that what this is how long before next activate. There we go. So pretty much this is how long it'll take for us to activate it again. I don't want this, so what we can do is I'm just going to do that. So if you want to add this in, just make sure to type in wait and not those two things. So that's pretty much how long we're going to wait for this thing to be activated again. I'm going to delete this since I just want it after we dupe our money, the proximity prompt will be activated again. Okay, now that we have this, we can go and close out of these scripts just like this, and we can press play here and it should work. Okay, if we were to hold for 3 seconds just like this, and then it should drop our money just like this. We can now hack the safe again, but if you put in a delay, we would have to wait another 20 seconds before being able to do that again. Then we can press C and our money will be collected, and we can hack this safe as much as we want. The benefit of cloning a part instead of just setting a part's position once, instead of just setting the part. So pretty much what you could do is you could also put 4 different things, and every time it goes, you can just set the position of them to be here. It's a bit more complicated, but this is simpler, and also you probably don't understand. Anyways, I'm just going to stop talking. Thank you for enjoying this video. Make sure to subscribe if you like this kind of content. I'm trying to post videos as much as I can, and leave a comment what you'd like to see next. Thank you for watching. Make sure to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye, everyone.